Some of them may be I cannot condone the deficit in the proposed laws that the government's action could produce a liability. And, you know, somebody is stealing my kitchen knife and using it as a murder weapon. It does not establish my liability for this murder. And how can the alcohol or this gun get stolen by a criminal and be used in the future? How can that establish my liability? Is this the same America that once liberated me from Hitler's power? This, at one time, was a power nation, populated by giants like George Washington and Thomas Jefferson, and a whole generation of heroes that once declared and laid open to the world that man's individual rights are unalienable, and that the security of these rights was the reason why governments are instituted among men. The consent of the government, in that same sentence of the declaration, the consent of the government to this day, the government to this day does not mean that we, the people, through the orderly process of democratic procedures, have empowered rulers to chip away and openly outright cancel our rights to our own lives, the liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
Wait, dear government, I'm going to turn it over to you, Doctor.
This is at stake for you.
I'm going to ask you to turn the testimony over to you, Doctor.
Okay, I need you to have a...
Thank you. My name is Bettina Romberg. I'm from Lowell. So I came here to talk to you about something that's very important to me. Actually, it's the most important thing to me in the world. It's my life. I love my life. I love my very existence. The United States are founded on a principle that protects my life. Thomas Jefferson wrote about it in the Declaration, the document without which we would not have a Commonwealth. He wrote that we have an unalienable right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Now, the first thing I have to outline here is the word right. What is a right? Rights are moral principles. They define and sanction my freedom to act in society. It means that I can act freely to pursue my life, my liberty, and my happiness, so long as I do not violate the rights of another individual. There is a reason why the first right is the right to my life. For one thing, without it, no other rights are possible. To have unalienable rights means my rights come from my nature as a human being and cannot be taken away by anyone. They are the reason we founded the United States, because our rights exist prior to government. The sole purpose of government is to preserve and protect my rights. The Second Amendment is part of my right to my own life. If I own my life, I have the right to the means to secure and protect it. The Second Amendment presupposes that my right to own and bear arms exists. It does not establish this right. It only states that this right of the people shall not be infringed. The Founding Fathers knew that their successors would one day be tempted to infringe on these rights for whatever arbitrary range of the moment, expediency, or excuse. The Second Amendment was written for the explicit purpose prohibit any and all infringements on my rights. Since I own my life by right, and I cannot violate the rights of another, it is clear that I can only use firearms in retaliation to defend myself against physical force, mainly against criminals the force to violate my rights. It is the express purpose of government to protect and secure my rights against criminals, if necessary, by the use of physical force, but again, only in retaliation, not by its initiation. This is especially important to me as a woman, as firearms are equalizers. I do not put myself in situations where I may have to use retaliatory physical force, but it is vitally important to me, to my life, that I am able to defend myself in case of emergency. There is no legal basis for the government to execute preemptive strikes against anyone. But that is exactly what is happening here when the government intends to chip away at the Second Amendment. The government becomes the initiators of physical force, infringing and violating my right to my own life, shirking its duty to protect my rights, thereby becoming indistinguishable from the criminals. The Second Amendment clearly states what you cannot do. So stop your rights infringing witch hunt. You have no moral leg to stand on. Thank you.